closer at the end of his shift. Tips one forward. Mikheyev was checked at the blue line. Here come the Kings. Dubois in on the right wing. P.L. Dubois cutting towards the goal. Centers the puck. They score!
This is the neutral zone turnover, and then this, as Fiala's unchecked coming in.
And they did only have four skaters. You
four players and then a player trying to get off the bench. It was the lotto line that was out for the tail end of that power play.
Pesci up the boards. Kotkaniemi hit by Martin. Puck knocked down by Cizikas. Hurricanes in a change. Here's Clutterbuck down the right wing with a shot. He scores!
Positions like this, it's a bad change as they exit out of the defensive zone. Carolina is not able to recover in time. The quick up by the Islanders and an outstanding shot by Clutterbuck gets this place rocking early.
Well, what a beautiful shot in the transition. A quick little pass there.
Sabres now will play it away from their pressure over on the left side of the ice. And with 6:15 to go, here's a breakaway. Vinny hit a scores!
Here's Robert Hägg with a long pass. Finds Vinny in a Stroza. You see the D just coming onto the ice. Orloff doesn't get back. Vinny in a Stroza gets in behind him, and the guy smashing his stick on the ice behind right there. That was the D coming off the bench. And Orloff, he's
that puck. He does enough to help the Capitals clear it down the ice. Zdeno Chara leading Capitals defenseman with penalty kill time this year. As we get a whistle.
Oh, I think they may be looking at too many men.
Yep.
Well, I couldn't read lips there, Dan. But
well, right now, there's a lot of Buffalo players on the ice right now. There's
it's too many men. Buffalo is the call here. So it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey here. Well, look at them all. There's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's too many. Too many to count. Too many to play.
Four. Smith, Gustafsson can't get that puck to settle down, and it goes out, and Gagne's on it. Sam Gagne moving in with Leonard Petrell. Gagne, shorthanded. Petrell fires the puck. He scores! Leonard Petrell, shorthanded goal! It's 2-1 Edmonton, and the celebration is on!
Right here, good defensive play. They're going to get just a little bit of that puck to bobble over Kostitsyn, and he finds his way to get through, takes a look back, knows that Petrella is coming, perfect pass.
As Jordan Staal walks all the way in, scores! Nathan Horton!
Seven thought nothing was happening right here. He's going to go for a line change, and Horton's going to skate right behind him in his wake, and even though you have plenty of Hurricanes that are guilty, Gleason one of them because he goes for the little curl and drag. Horton just pulls it right around him, and a beautiful top shelf finish. I mean, that is an impressive.
As Cross deflected off from McLeod. Hamlet, his stick handle his way in. And here's a rip down the ice by Henderson. Oh, and look at this! Bad change, pass, score! McLeod sets up Hendricks, and the Avalanche have a 4-1 lead on that shorthanded goal. What a horrible change by Minnesota.
Mike, you see stuff all the time that is the first time. I have never seen a situational worse change than this one. They ice the puck. Look, everybody from Minnesota turns, and I guarantee you should have seen Hendricks and McLeod. They were both like, what? Their body language was like, what? Just happened. Now the puck goes down and Backstrom can't come out and get it. But what a pretty play at the end. Won by Hendricks. A nice pass to McLeod. But then McLeod, watch the body language. Whoa! That's the breakaway time.
With less than 15 seconds to go, in on a forward, drops the puck back. Petrangelo to the net, scores! With 8 seconds to go in the first period, Alex Petrangelo has made it 2-0 St. Louis.
Brad Marchand, he's dead tired. He looks and says, okay, I got a chance to change. Instead, no change is made. He misses his man, Schwartz. Now the change is late, and everybody's trying to come back to the net. Schwartz does a good job of making sure he keeps the puck alive, takes a quick look back, and forehand backhand Petrangelo.
turned it over to Paquette, and it's good back down the ice.
Riley looking for a hooking penalty there. He might have a pretty good case.
Tavares was pleading in his hole. Turnover front, Hedman across, scores! Cedric Paquette.
And right by Paquette, a little bit of a hook that went uncalled. And then it goes all the way down now to the goal. And it becomes a 3-on-1. And Riley's the only one back on this play, as the Leafs are on a change, and a horrible change. And when they change, that turns into a 3-on-1. And the end result is Sparks.
To Blay, 3-on-2 across the line. Through Bozak, Thomas scores! After all that, it's the Blues on their first shot of the game.
Pitched on with the exit. The Stars go for a change. 3-on-2 turns into a semi-breakaway, and Thomas just blows it right past the shoulder of Hudobin.
A nice feed by Sammy Blay and a really smart play by Tyler Bozak. He drives to the net 21, so he's going to take the defenseman away. That creates time and
wait. Get back to the blue line before Nyquist dumped the puck in, and now Foodies, he got it on a Toronto change. He takes a shot. He scores! Bank shot by Frederick Anderson as the Maple Leafs were changing, and Liam Foodie has made this 2-0 Columbus.
Jim, the key word there is the Leafs were changing, but they were late. They were late making a change. Some confusion against at the bench. This is a turn back by Nyquist. Look at all the bodies make a change. They didn't realize, though, that the one guy in there was Liam Foodie. He's in all by himself. Morenson standing and just protecting nothing. Got to go tack. Players are late coming, and this one finds off the right side of Anderson. Watch Anderson's response here. He can't believe, A, that there's a Columbus Blue.
Drop pass, Malkin across, and read well by Tanev, who knocked the pass away intended for Phil Kessel. Canucks on a sloppy change here. Kessel moves in. Here's Malkin, shoots, scores!
Throw it back to your own bench, and here you can see the Canucks, nobody's coming on, and Malkin takes full advantage. There it is, and you can see the guys, half of them have the legs over the bench, and nobody gets on the ice. They're afraid to touch it, and Malkin, a great shot up and over the shoulder of Ryan Miller.